today in the presence of the good Lord up above and this beautiful setting, the serenading of everything behind me, and what a beautiful night it's going to be. An opportunity to gather and give thanks for James and Chelsea as they choose to engage in a covenant of marriage this evening. I'm just honored to be here together. Thank you for that. Looking forward to sharing with them and talking with them, and then share with each other. We went through this. Let me just share a couple of things that you probably already know that we talked about. Marriage is something that you have to continually work on. But it's joy. It's endurance. It's strength. It's companionship. It's encouragement. And it's standing with each other even through the difficult times. It's making sure what you entering into the season, do so wholeheartedly, full intentions and good intentions. We're in agreement on all that. Maybe that's a really good start. Okay. Did you speak some of the rules? Scripture reading for this evening say 1 John 4:16-19, one that I really believe is a good foundation for a couple that says, so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in love lives in God and God in him. In this way, love is made complete among us so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. Because in this world we are like you. There is no fear in love. The perfect love drives out fear. Fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We love because he first loved us. Believe God add his blessing to the reading of this word. Amen. Alright. So the first part was just your intent to marry. Now we're going to go into the vows. We want to make sure this sticks. Knowing your sense of humor, I thought you would appreciate that. Okay. Good benefit. I, James, thank you, Chelsea, to be my wife, my constant friend, my faithful partner, and my love from this day forward. In the presence of God, our family and friends, I offer you my solemn vow to be your faithful partner in sickness. And in health, in good times and bad, as well as sorrow. I promise to love you unconditionally, to laugh with you and cry with you, to cherish you for as long as you both shall be. Okay, Chelsea. Hi, Chelsea.
Hi, Chelsea.
Thank you, James.
Thank you, James.
Be my husband.
Be my husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
My love from this day forward.
In the presence of God,
our family and friends,
our family and friends,
I offer you my solemn vow to be your faithful partner in sickness,
to be your faithful partner in sickness,
in health,
in health,
in good times and in bad,
in good times and bad,
joy as well as sorrow,
in joy as well as sorrow.
We talk about the exchange of rings, we talk about the faithfulness, we talk about the circle of love that only Christ can create in the relationship coming into this marriage. And I'm excited as I spend time talking about love that we don't need to like give up that. It was really incredible to see how much they'd already grown together, and very honored to be here today. As you see the outward expression of their love for each other by the exchanging of the rings. So, vested in me by the state of Texas and Lord God Almighty, and I gratefully acknowledge His presence and His acceptance of this covenant. I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss and ride.
Woo!
Watch it, James, you may fall.
Okay, this time I'll present to you James and Chelsea, Mr. and Mrs. Bartley.
Yay!
Back over the bridge.
You gotta catch the bridge. Oh, I wasn't leading nobody. A beautiful family.